U.S. military to strike warship with a pair of naval strike missiles. This morning, the German military tweeted that one member of the Afghan security forces at the airport in Kabul had been killed, and three others were wounded by unknown attackers. In their tweet, the German army said, "This morning at 4:13 a.m., there was an exchange of fire between Afghan guards and unknown assailants at the north gate of Kabul airport. An Afghan guard was killed, three others injured." American and German forces participated in further exchange of fire, it said, adding that no German soldiers were injured. Kabul airport has seen chaotic scenes as tens of thousands of foreigners and Afghans seek to flee Afghanistan after the Taliban swept back to power more than a week ago.
Move forward!
Hit the circle.
The U.S. confirms they have evacuated 33,000 people, including at least 2,500 Americans. Afghanistan's security forces collapsed in the face of the Taliban advance, despite 20 years of Western aid, training, and assistance. But some armed Afghans remain at Kabul airport, assisting Western evacuation reports. U.S. Marines, participating in large-scale exercise 2021, employed a pair of naval strike missiles that traveled more than 100 nautical miles through simulated mountain ranges and shipping lanes before striking a naval target ship at sea. Major Nicholas Manwheeler, U.S. Marine Corps Forces Pacific, reports. The live fire, long-range precision strike mission was the first tactical demonstration of the flexibility and lethality enabled by Marine Expeditionary Advanced Bases, a key component of the Marine Corps' Force Design 2030 efforts. Marines and sailors from 1st Battalion, 12th Marines carried out the mission August 15th, 2021, aboard Pacific Missile Range Facility Barking Sands on the Hawaiian island of Kauai. The missiles were fired from a Navy Marine Expeditionary Ship Interdiction System launcher. Their operation began days earlier, landing ashore using U.S. Navy Landing Craft Air Cushion Hovercraft and MV-22B Osprey Tilt Rotor Aircraft. Once on the beach, the Marines and sailors of 112 established a firing position, set security perimeters, and deployed cutting-edge command and control technology to support their combat operations center. The unit used the Networking on the Move utility task vehicle, which resembles a dune buggy mounted with wireless satellite communications equipment. These new systems and capabilities represent a major change for the artillery community as it shifts focus to implement Force Design 2030 concepts and refine its support to distributed maritime operations. But one particular piece of equipment attracted the Marines' attention through the exercise, a Nemesis launcher. Many Marines recognize the familiar form of a joint light tactical vehicle, a tall, heavy-duty truck built for tough conditions in tough places. Smoke and flames billowed from the damaged sections of the ship just as the Nemesis' second missile found its mark. In the interests of avoiding an adversary's counterattack, the Nemesis launcher followed its leader vehicle to a Marine KC-130J waiting on the nearby airfield. Artillery Marines and KC-130 loadmasters worked together to maneuver the Nemesis inside the body of the plane. The aircraft and Nemesis stayed on the ground, but the evolution highlighted the system's ability to go to any location serviceable by a KC-130.
Thank you.